गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट अवर थर्ड लेसन रिलीजियस सिंथेसिस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ सी, इन आवर कंट्री डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस एंड रिलीजियस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी। कंसिडरिंग दिस फीचर, द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हैज अडॉप्टेड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सेकुलरिज्म। इन मिडिवल इंडिया, to attempt to bring about religious synthesis in social life were made on the basis of the principle. Among these efforts, the Bhakti movement, Sikhism and the Sufi sect have an significant places. These different streams of thought arose in different part of India. They emphasize harmony between the different sect and religions among the devotion to God. We shall study them in this chapter. Now see, rituals and Brahmajnan were greatly emphasized in the Indian religious life. In the medieval period, they gave way to Bhakti Marga. Bhakti Marga means the path of devotions. Now we find different forms of the path of devotion. According to the local situation there, the Bhakti movement used to common people's language instead of Sanskrit. This helped the development of religious or regional languages. Now see Bhakti movement. It is believed that the Bhakti movement originated in the South India. The Nayanar and Alwar Bhakti movements emerged in this region. The Nayanar were devotee of Shiva, while the Alwars were devotee of Vishnu. Shiva and Vishnu, two important sects. There were also attempt to consider Shiva and Vishnu as one and the same and bring them together. Harihar, idols which depict half Vishnu and half Shiva, were produced in this period on a large scale. People belonging to all social strata had participated in these Bhakti movements. They purged values like love of God, humanity, compassion, mercy, etc. Ramanuj and other Acharyas trained the base of the Bhakti movement in South India. They told people that God is for all. God does not discriminate. The teachings of Ramanuj had a great impact in the North India also. Saint Ramanan strengthened the Bhakti movement in North India. Saint Kabir is a well-known saint in the Bhakti movement. He did not attach any importance to places of pilgrimage, vratas or idol worships. For example, truth was God. He thought that all human beings are equal. He did not believe any difference based on a caste, creed, sect and religion. He wanted to bring about Hindu and Muslim unity. He criticized the extreme orthodox people in the both Hindu and Muslim religion in strong terms. In Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu underlined the importance of Krishna Bhakti. Due to his teaching, people joined the Bhakti movement in transcending the boundaries of caste and creed. Under his influence, Shankaradeva spread the Bhakti movement in Assam. Narsi Mehta was a renowned Vaishnav saint in Gujarat. He was an ordinate devotee of Krishna. He gave the message of equality. He is known as the first poet of the Gujarati language. As well as Saint Mirabai stressed the importance of devotion of Krishna. She belonged to the royal family of Mewar. She now renounced all pleasure of the royal family and immersed herself in devotion to Krishna. She composed devotional verses in Rajasthani and Gujarati. Her devotional verses give the message of devotion or tolerances and humanity. Saint Sena was an influential saint. Saint Ruidas was a great saint. He gave the message of equality and humanity. Surdasa, a great poet of Hindu literature, composed a poetical work, Sursagar. It means devotion to Krishna. Krishna Bhakti is the subject of his work. The verses on Krishna Bhakti, composed by the Muslim saint Raz Khan, are melodious. Ramcharitmanas of Saint Tulsidas is a beautiful composition expressing devotion of Rama. In Karnataka, Basveshwar spared the Lingayat stream of thought. He opposed the caste system and stressed the dignity of labor. Kankav Kailas is his well-known saying, which means work is Kailas. It means work is worship. He encouraged women's participation in movement. Men and women belong to all caste began to participate in the religious discussion conducted in the hall Anubhav Manatapa. Sri Basveshwar conveys his teaching in the language of the people, is that Kannada. Through the medium of Vichan literature, his work had a great impact on society. His followers have composed their work in Marathi also of this composition. Paramacharya, composed by Mannath Swami, is very known great saint in Karnataka. Include Pam, Purandas and other they compose many devotional verses in Kannada. The next one is Mahanubhav sect. In the 30th century, Chakradas Swami founded the Mahanubhav Panth in Maharashtra. This sect purged devotion is to Krishna. Sri Govind Prabhu was the guru of Chakradas Swami. The followers of Chakradar included men and women belong to all caste and creeds. He supported equality. He traveled to all parts of Maharashtra, preaching in Marathi. He preferred Marathi instead of Sanskrit. This led to the development of many Marathi languages. Many works were composed in Marathi. This sect mainly spread in the Vidarbha and Marathwada region of Maharashtra. Riddhipur in Vidarbha is an important place for people of this sect. This sect had reached up to far away region like the Punjab and Afghanistan. Next, Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhs and the first guru of Sikhs. His work has to be mentioned as a great attempt at a religious synthesis. He visited the holy places of both Hindus and Muslims. Had also visited Mecca, he realized that the feeling of devotion is common everywhere. He taught that all persons should be treated equally. His teaching aimed at achieving Hindu-Muslim unity. Many people were influenced by the teaching of Guru Nanak. The number of his followers increased day by day. The followers of Guru Nanak are known as Sikh in Siyasas, meaning disciplines. The Adi Granth, also known as the Guru Granth Sahib, is the holy book of the Sikh. The Adi Granth includes composition of Guru Nanak, Saint Namdev, Saint Kabir and other saints. Guru Nanak was succeeded by 9th Guru of Sikh. Guru Gobind Singh was the 10th Guru of Sikh. After Guru Gobind Singh, Sikhs regard the Guru Granth Sahib as their gurus as per the orders of Guru Granth Gobind Singh. The last Sufi sect. This is a sect in Islam. The Sufi saint believe that God is full of love and the only way to reach him is through love and devotion. Their main teaching are love for all living beings. Meditation and simple living, Khwaja Mundin Krist, Sheikh Nizamuddin Awliya were great Sufi saints. The teaching of Sufi saints led to unity in the Hindu and Muslim communities. Sufi music has made valuable contribution to Indian music. The path of bhakti taught by the saint was easy to follow for the common people. The bhakti movement was open to all men and women. The saint expressed their thoughts in the language of the people. The common people found them close to their heart. The bhakti movement has contributed greatly to the making of the Indian culture. So dear student, in the next video we will going to study about our question answers.